Now, without a doubt, one of the fan favorite characters within the Star Wars franchise is indeed Darth Vader, aka Anakin Skywalker, that a lot of fans have seen since the prequel trilogy, the originals, and yes, even Rogue One, A Star Wars Story. This is Mike Zero. Make sure to subscribe if you're new to the channel for future Star Wars content. Now, with Darth Vader returning in several new Star Wars projects, one, for example, of course, being the Star Wars Kenobi series, which is filming as we speak, that's going to begin significant levels of principal photography this March of 2021, so looking forward to that. Now, just yesterday, all right, Lucasfilm dropped a lot of titles for the upcoming Star Wars projects. Not all of them, however, but the first batch of projects that they are actually already working on. Next year, by the way, we will be getting major new announcements on additional TV shows, movies, and more. However, what's really exciting is the fact that we have actor Hayden Christensen actually coming back into the Star Wars universe, portraying Anakin slash Darth Vader in not just the Kenobi series, but the Ahsoka Tano show and other animated and live-action shows out there. Now, with the character of Darth Vader, this is a very beloved character that Lucasfilm really has to be very, very careful with. We have seen what they did with Rogue One, A Star Wars Story, which I thought was amazing. I think it was honestly Disney's best Star Wars movie out there because of how it felt, how close it really felt to the original trilogy and how it really stayed to the roots of Star Wars, at least in my opinion. It didn't go too overboard with anything. Now, when we look at everything related to Darth Vader, what's really exciting is what they have in store for the future. Now, with the Skywalker saga now over, both Disney and Lucasfilm are focused on their new Star Wars universe and more. It's described that creators Jon Favreau, George Lucas, and Deborah Chow are about to establish a game-changing retcon to the new Star Wars universe that will significantly impact the character of Darth Vader. It's described that Lucasfilm is developing a plan that is moving forward that will involve both Obi-Wan Kenobi and Darth Vader to have one final duel across the galaxy through using a new force power that will be revisited. Apart from that, this new power is described to be a flash fight sequence that will involve both Kenobi and Darth Vader fighting across the galaxy. Though Rey and Kylo Ren have already performed this type of duel at a short distance in the sequel trilogy, Lucasfilm plans to create a new meaning to the line from A New Hope of Vader stating, "Sense something, a presence I've not felt since," as well as adding more context to the line, "You should have not come back." On top of that, it's noted that Lucasfilm knows that this may very well be a controversial decision on their end between themselves and the fans, and that they are planning to film scenes of Vader on Tatooine in the Kenobi TV series for Disney Plus and more. So let's stop right there for a second. What's really exciting about Darth Vader's return is that what they are trying to craft here, what they're ultimately trying to do, is that they're trying to add more to the character of Vader and how we see Vader in the original trilogy movies. Now, this is one thing that I think a lot of fans might have an issue with, is because, well, Vader and Kenobi were supposed to last seen each other on Mustafar, and that was it. Of course, in the comics, in the actual comics related to Kenobi, Vader does indeed go to Tatooine. And so you can see now that they are trying to at least mimic that, but never have we actually had a full-on fight between Kenobi and Vader. Now, let's go into this a little bit further, because this is a very interesting angle. Now, we've talked about how they are indeed going to be introducing next-generation CGI technology in the Star Wars Kenobi series, specifically meant for the visions, dream sequences, and a very detailed actual sequence between Kenobi and Darth Vader, actually suited up by Hayden Christensen. Now, the thing about this is that one of the sequences, at the very minimum, is going to be a vision. Now, this is a very interesting thing, is because they are going to take advantage of using both Kenobi and Vader on the world of Mustafar, and eventually they want to shift away from the visions and dream sequences in the show to actually having Vader and Kenobi meet once again. That, to me, I'm not quite sure once again how fans are going to take that. I, however, think it's a very creative idea by, George, Jon Favreau, Deborah Chow, Lucasfilm creatives. But at the same exact time, it does somewhat change how we view A New Hope, and it does mess around with the canon lore. So I'm a little on edge of really saying whether or not I fully support this. I'm really confused as to whether or not this is the real way to go. I'm not quite sure how I really feel about it, but visually speaking, I think it's going to be an amazing thing to actually witness, to actually have Kenobi and Vader meet once again, and to add more context and or meaning to those two lines by Vader. You know, those two lines by Vader in A New Hope are very powerful, and Lucasfilm wants to add more to that. So, given that this series is going to take place 10 years after Revenge of the Sith, alright, we're getting closer to, you know, the point in time where we're getting more near so with A New Hope and more. It's going to be a very interesting bridge, if you will. So, like I've said before in the past, guys, you know, drop a comment below. Let me know about all of this in the comments. And if you guys did enjoy the content for today, do make sure to drop a thumbs up on this video to support the channel. I thank you all so very much for the kind support, and I'll catch you guys next time.